Hey, I'm Robert with Intel here at CES 2026, and a big topic in the PC industry, as we all know, is the price of memory. So all of the industry partners are doing what they can to bring down the cost of gaming, to make PC gaming accessible to folks. Yep. You know, Intel's doing what they can, and of course, ASRock is doing what they can. I'm here with Chris of ASRock, and we've got some new motherboards we want to talk about today. Some with the DDR4, some with DDR5. Some of them at really nice prices. Why don't you tell us about the lineup here?
Sure, Robert. Yeah. So this time, because of DDR4, DDR5 price right now is crazy. So what we're going to do to bring to our users is what we can do from the motherboard perspective,
right?
So we have more like an affordable motherboard lineup this year, showcase at CES, and we're going to mass production it. We're going to sell it really soon. I mean, in
Q1. So let's start with an interesting option here.
We saw
this one, it's an H610 board. Why don't you talk us through why this one is so interesting?
Yeah, this one is what we call the H610M Combo. Combo boards. Combo means DDR4 plus DDR5.
So it has D4 and D5
slots.
And D4
and D5 slots on the same board, right?
That's cool.
So imagine this. So usually you have a two DIMM slots or four DIMM slots on motherboards, right? But this board has a six DIMM slots. That's a two DDR4 plus four DDR5.
Yeah.
So imagine this, because right now the D4, D5 price, changes every day.
Every day.
Our customers, Disney customers, they cannot expect today they get DDR4, tomorrow maybe they cannot get DDR4, they get DDR5. So this board is designed for them. It's easier for them to have their stock inventory. So it's flexible for them.
Right.
Today, if they get DDR4, they can,
easily choose that.
If they can choose this board, tomorrow they get DDR5 with a decent price, they can, easily to put it on the same board.
So they can upgrade and transition over
it's
time.
It's flexible for them.
Yeah, okay. And then you were telling me also about the new ROC lineup of motherboards.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, because usually, we define ROC is more like an entry for budget users.
Okay.
But the important thing is before, those kind of entry boards, you usually have a, not so fancy design,
But these look really clean and sleek.
Exactly, yeah. It's because, we think it's, right now, especially, again, the DRAM price is so high,
right?
So what we can do is we provide affordable motherboard, but with a sleek, with a simple design, users can still enjoy, pretty, decent look of the,
So trying to make up costs somewhere
else
in the system.
Absolutely. So we have our two boards here. It's a BA60, both a BA60 chipsets, ATX and micro ATX. It's a ROC Wi-Fi 7 boards. Design is great using the Wi-Fi 7 technology, and even the 2 DIMM is usually is just look like normal boards.
Sure.
But this time we make it really, I really love the design.
Well, even with 2 DIMMs, right, that's a lot of memory capacity these days, and
good
for overclocking, good for frequency. So that's the right thing to do.
Yeah,
these boards look great. Chris, what else do we need to know about ASRock at CES today?
We also have a Challenger. Challenger is more like for the segmentation, it's a bit higher than the ROC. But it's also, having, all
heck
great
of a
features.
Board, really beautiful board.
Yeah, it is. It's also a brand new, ID design with this board. And one of the cool thing is, on the back side, there's two yellow ports.
Yeah.
It's what we call the lightning gaming ports.
Uh-huh.
It's for the, high pulling rate.
That's
keyboard
right.
and mouse, they go from different paths, so it will not interference each other.
Okay, so lower click latency, essentially.
Exactly, low latency, right?
That's really cool.
So this is also designed for the game.
All right.
Mainstream gamers.
There we go. Okay, so that's ASRock at CES 2026. They have a lot of other stuff in this booth. We're just scratching the surface with these motherboards, but the key here is memory innovation is alive and well in this industry, even in tough times with DRAM. We're all trying to find ways to make gaming more affordable and more accessible for people. We've got the ROC lineup, we've got the Challenger lineup, combo boards. Things are looking pretty nice this year.
Yeah.
Thanks, Chris. Really appreciate
your
time.
Thank you, Robert. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Of course.